G'day viewers, this tank has not had a water change for 10 weeks. So stick around to find out how I managed to do that without killing all of the fish. We'll have a quick talk about what anoxic filtration is, a quick look at the basket, and then we'll measure the nitrates, phosphates, and TDS in this tank. And I'll also try and answer all of your questions that I've received over the course of these updates. So, what is anoxic filtration? Anoxic filtration is essentially a way of completing the nitrogen cycle using a low oxygen environment. As the water flows around the basket, the ammonia which has a positive charge is attracted into the clay which has a negative charge. And as it gets drawn further into the basket, our typical beneficial aerobic bacteria converts it into nitrite and nitrates, drawing oxygen out of the water. And as we get further into the basket, where we have a low oxygen environment, we hope to colonise another kind of bacteria, which gets its oxygen off the nitrate molecule. So it uses all those O's off the molecule and leaves only the N, which is nitrogen gas, which is safe. That's completing the nitrogen cycle. So what about the BCB basket itself? Well, this is what it looks like. I won't really get into it too much because I did make a video of how I made it and what I put in it, and I'll put a link for that down in the description as soon as I convince my kids to show me how to do it. And the main question I get asked is about the kitty litter. It's 100% New Zealand zeolite clay and it's non-clumping and it doesn't melt in the water. And just for my mate at the Acu Health Nature Cure Institute, this is what it looks like and how big it is. I hope that helps. And there's the basket in the sump, and I've recently made a second basket a little bit lower so I can put charcoal bags or whatever I want on top. And that is made from 100% organic Australian zeolite. Because I'm sure, as you know viewers, anything the New Zealanders can do, Australians will do better. And both baskets have fluorite, the original, for the iron source. So, let's test some water. Here's the part you've all been waiting for, the big test. It'd be pretty boring watching all of this, so we'll speed it up. We'll put it in the corner, and we'll have a look at what's happened over the last 10 weeks. So, 10 weeks ago, the tank was at about 5 parts per million. And it didn't really increase over the first couple of weeks, and then started to sneak up towards that 10, and eventually, up around 20. And by about week 7 or 8, it started to creep up just over that 20 to probably closer to 30. And by week 9, it was about 30. And there's the result. At week 10, it's probably not dark enough to call it 40. I'd say it's probably more like about 36.5 parts per million. Which I think in anyone's book is a pretty good result, whether you believe in anoxic filtration or not. So now we'll perform a quick phosphate test to see if those levels have increased over 10 weeks without a water change. As you can see, not really, still at 0.1 parts per million, so you've got to be happy with that. We'll also do a quick pH test to make sure we haven't had any drama there. It normally runs about 6.8 because this tank does run on rainwater, which is naturally pretty soft and pretty acidic to begin with. And there we are at about 6.6, so we're happy with that. Now we'll check our TDS, or total dissolved solids. As I said, this is rainwater, so it's pretty soft to begin with. If we have a look, we're at 66 parts per million, which is pretty good because I'm keeping South American cichlids. So there we have it, viewers. While we haven't achieved zero nitrates, I think going from 5 parts per million to less than 40 in 10 weeks is a step in the right direction. So I'll break out the good old Colin from Aussie Aquatic approved water change device and I'll perform a nice big water change and we'll see how we go from here. So hopefully this video is giving you something to think about and hopefully it answers all of your questions. But if not, feel free to fire away down below. I'd love to hear from you. So that about wraps it up for today. So if you like leaving likes, leave a like. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.
Thanks for stopping by. Please remember to like and subscribe and check out one of these videos.